I want Hindus to know there's a clear, powerful anti-Hindu ecosystem gets billions of dollars from outside India every year for this kind of a terrorist activities, for mob lynching and for conversion, and constantly to wage lawfare on Hindu gurus and Hindu leaders. Understand? First, the media funded by anti-Hindus, the mainstream media, Indian media is the worst corrupt media, prostitutes. I have a small story. One clinical trial research specialist, doctors, how they do the clinical trial on new medicines. On animals, they do the clinical trial first and then on human beings. One top guy who does clinical trials, he tells his assistants, we have decided to use journalists in India instead of rats for testing the medicines. The assistants asked, why? Two reasons. One, more number of journalists are found than the rats. Second, there are some things the rats are not ready to do for money. Worst corrupt media in the world. They will do anything for money and their TRP. And I tell you, this media drives the politicians and their decisions. The media drives end to end. They drive the officials and their decisions. They drive the police and their decisions. They drive politicians and their decisions. The media cult in India has decided to eliminate Hinduism from India. And it is absolutely heavily funded and owned by anti-Hindus. When I say media, not only the news channels, entertainment channels, I include the cinema industry, entertainment industry. Heavily anti-Hindu, directly, indirectly, in every small, every frame shown in the movies are aimed, focused in destroying Hinduism, Hindu culture. It is detailed, deeply micromanaged. 99% of the movie space, screen space is dedicated to anti-Hindu ideas and eliminating Hinduism, Hindu thought currents, Hindu ideas, everything related to Hinduism. Making the person illegitimate, antisocial, calling the dog as mad dog so that you can shoot it. That's the first thing in this whole strategy. Then singling out. Singling out means making even all the other Hindu gurus and Hindu leaders hate this person and distance. I have seen that. Singling out. Then eliminate him. Either make him as the make him as, oh, he committed suicide. Or mob lynch and create a mob video, oh, he was raping a girl and that girl killed him. Too easy. All these stories. Or in the prison, there are some hardcore criminals who are already convicted for lifetime. Just secretly release them in the night. They will go and eliminate, kill that person and come back. So no evidence will be left. And this person officially, legally, formally, he was in the jail. So nobody can be in investigation. Nothing will be found. Nobody will be convicted. These are all the great techniques adopted by Dravish gang. It's a continuous happening. Every day happening. Very few gets reported. In multi-level, singling out hate speech. Dumping the large quantity of the hate speech, brainwashing the mass against the Hindu leader or Hindu guru, and then lawfare, and finally eliminate him through the mob lynching. Over. The amount of hate speech the Indian media prostitutes dumped on me or on the, all the Hindu gurus and Hindu leaders. It is just to terrorize others. Hey, see what we have done to Nityananda. Be careful. Mass media, cult of India. Is focused on destroying Hinduism, eliminating all the Hindu leaders and Hindu gurus one by one, and ultimately eliminating the whole Hinduism. See, we Hindus are actually indigenous traditions. Each tradition has its own way of living and everything. And this mass media cult and their masterminds, they are such criminals and conspirators. They know how to use our differences and make the differences into fault lines and break Hinduism. I tell you, the whole ecosystem driven by the mass media cult prostitutes in India is out to eliminate Hinduism within next one or two generations. Oh Hindus, unless you wake up now, I don't want to even visualize what may happen if you don't wake up. I just request all of you to wake up. That's all.